I just felt like sharing a word with you. I shared this with our youth on Wednesday night about stepping out in faith. I know a lot of us have probably been struggling with that probably in the last week. You've probably been struggling with that for quite some time. And this afternoon, I'm going to read about a man that struggled with something for a long time. We're going to be in John chapter 5, and we're going to read the first 9 verses. And then with the Lord's help, we'll just try to guide through this and share with what God has put on our heart. In chapter 5, verse 1, it says, "After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. And there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having 5 porches. In there lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in was made whole of whatever or whatsoever disease he had. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie, and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he saith unto him, Wilt thou be made whole? The impotent man answered him, Sir, I have no man, when the water is troubled, to put me into the pool. But while I am coming, another steppeth down before me. Jesus saith unto him, Rise, take up thy bed, and walk. And immediately the man was made whole, and took up his bed, and walked. And on the same day was the Sabbath." We're going to pray, and with the Lord's help, I want to focus on that topic, stepping out in faith. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this scripture that you've provided, that you've laid on our heart. We pray, God, it will touch those that are listening to this, and that it will just grab a hold of those heartstrings, and it will just go further and further in their life. We just thank you, God, and just ask all this in your sweet and gracious heavenly name. Amen. All right, so I want to talk about how to prepare to step out in faith. Number one thing we need to do is we need to pray. I know a lot of times we try to figure it out on our own. We don't seek God's guidance before we do step out in faith. Sometimes we get ourselves in just a pickle and we don't know which way to turn. Things are not just working out the way that we thought that they should have worked out. And our plans are completely demolished. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 through 18, it says, "Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you." What we see here in this particular scripture is that several people, in verses 3, we see that several people, a multitude, a great multitude, gathered at Bethesda's pool because in verse 4 they had heard that an angel would come down at certain times and would trouble those waters. And when they would do that, when the trouble was water, the first one to step into that pool was completely healed of what they were going through. And so we see here that they were praying, that they were focused on this angel that was coming to this water. They had hopes and high regard. They knew if they got into that pool first, that they would be completely healed. So the second thing I want to talk about is that we need to be prepared to wait. We need to be prepared to wait. Oh, that's hard for me sometimes, knock on my head. That's hard for me sometimes to be prepared to wait, to know that God's going to answer my prayers, but I want it now, God. I want it right now at this time and what I'm going through. I don't want to wait. So we need to be prepared to wait. Psalms 27, verse 14, it says, wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. We see here that this man in verse 5 had been this way for 38 years. He had been this way for 38 years. He had waited. He had heard the stories of Bethesda's pool. He knew exactly what needed to be done. He knew he had to get into that water to be healed. But he tells Jesus here that I don't have men to put me into the water. And every time that I try to get into the water, somebody beats me to it. So he's been this way for 38 years. I'm 33 years old. And I feel like I've lived a lifetime. And a lot of y'all might be laughing about that. But it seems like it was forever ago that I graduated high school. Me and my wife are celebrating our 10-year anniversary, wedding anniversary today. But we've been dating for 18 years. It seems like forever ago that happened. It's been 20 years since I gave my heart to the Lord Jesus Christ. It's been 16 years since I announced my calling to preach. It feels like a complete lifetime. And some of y'all are older than me, and a lot of those times seem further back, and I'm sure they are. But to me, 33 years waiting on something would be disastrous for me. I don't want to wait 10 minutes on God sometimes. I don't want to wait 38 years for God to answer my prayers, but this guy waited at this pool for 38 years. For 38 years, he waited for a remedy, and every time he kept getting passed over. Every time he told Jesus, he had no idea who Jesus was, but he told him here that every time the water's troubled, I don't have anybody to put me in there, and every time I try to get in there, somebody jumps ahead of me. I want you to know right now, in your instance right now, that a lot of times we want our answer right now, then, and we don't want to wait for our answer from God. We know to trust God, and we know that we sometimes have to wait on God, but we're impatient people. I'm very impatient, like I just shared. I've lived a lifetime of happiness. I've lived a lifetime of sadness. I went through grieving processes. I went through sinful processes. I went through backsliding processes. I went through doubting. And obviously stepping out on faith is something tough sometimes. But this man for 38 years waited by this pool. And I just can't imagine what was going through his head. Wanting to come out of his mouth every time he gets passed up. 38 years, y'all. 38 years he waited. Thirdly, I want to look at, we've got to be able to accept the outcome. I know that's easier said than done. I know it is. I've lived it. It's not always went my way. I've been in situations where, God, I thought this is where you wanted me to be. God, I thought this was your answer to my prayers. But then all of a sudden it's over. And then I get in a little pity mode. And I get frustrated. And I get angry. And I start pointing fingers at other people. And I start asking myself what I could have done better. And the number one thing I could have done better was I could have trusted in Jesus more. Jeremiah 29, verse 11, says, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. God has an outcome for us, y'all. He has an outcome for us all. And it may not be exactly what we want. It may not be exactly how we envisioned it. We think a lot of times that God has turned his back on us, that God is up there in the heavens with a magnifying glass burning us like we're little ants on an anthill. But I'm here to tell you that we serve a God in heaven that loves us unconditionally. We are every day spitting in God's face. Why are we doing that? Because a lot of times we step out and we try to figure it out on our own. We try to do it all on our own. We don't look to God. We don't trust God. We're not stepping out in faith. If you look in the Bible where Peter saw Jesus walking on the water, and this is a great scenario with this. When Jesus was walking on the water, and Peter said, "Let me step out there with you," and he said, "Come." Peter stepped out. And Peter was walking on the water, y'all. Peter was on the water, walking just like Jesus. Why? Because his face was on the King. His face was on Jesus. His trust was in Jesus. His faith was in Jesus. But the second that a storm came through, his eyes fell off of Jesus. What happened there? What happened there, you ask? He lost his focus on Jesus. He wasn't praying to Jesus at that time. He wasn't waiting on Jesus at that time. And the outcome that he was expecting was the perish in the sea. And that's exactly what happened. He began to sink. He began to sink, and he knew he was in trouble. And he knew that he was going to die right there in that sea. But you know what he did? He said, "Jesus, Jesus, save me." And you know what's amazing about that? What's amazing about that is that we all the time take our eyes off of Jesus. And we all the time put our eyes on the world. And we all the time try to combat each other. And we all the time try to figure it out on our own. Jesus didn't walk by Peter and said, "Well, you just took your eyes off of me. I guess you're just going to have to figure it out on your own." Peter didn't fall in that sea and say, "I'm going to figure it out on my own." He was desperate for help. And that's how we are sometimes. When things are just terrible and we don't know which way to turn, we are calling upon Jesus in those times. Buddy of mine told me the other day, go ahead and start praising God now. Start praising Jesus now, because he has already answered your prayer. And it may not be answered tomorrow. It may not be answered today. I want to encourage you to know that God has this. He has it all in control. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 through 6 encourages us that it says, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not on unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths." Ain't it amazing? Ain't it amazing that we serve a God that we can trust in with all our hearts? You may not trust me. You may be watching this video. You may have not even made it this far in this video. You may have done went on ahead and scrolled on by. And that's fine. That's fine. But I know that there's somebody out there that needs to hear this message. There's somebody out there that is struggling with stepping out in faith, and they don't know what to do. We've done looked at what to do. We need to pray. We need to be prepared to wait, and we need to be able to accept the outcome. I want to look at Hebrews 11, verses 6 through 12, and I want to look at some people. You say, "That's easy said and done, preacher. That's easier said and done, Kevin." But I want you to look at some people that we lived here, look up in here. And this whole chapter is just amazing. It talks about Enoch and it talks about Abel. But I want to look at, starting at verse 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as of yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go into a place which he should have to receive for an inheritance, obeyed. And he went out, not knowing whither he went. By faith, he sojourned in the land of promise, as in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder and maker is God. Through faith, Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child when she was past of age, because she judged him faithful who had promised. We look in this scripture here, and it talks about people that had faith. We look at Noah and Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and Sarah. But what stands out to this scripture here, to me, is verse 10. Talking about Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob going on the same promise. I'm telling you, today is August the 13th, 2021, and I'm going on the same promise that I accepted Jesus Christ on in September of 2001. I'm going on the same promise that my dad trusted him when he gave his heart to the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going on the same promise that my papa, that I've never met on this side of heaven, trusted in and gave his heart to the Lord Jesus Christ. For he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder and maker is of God. We look upon this land and all these things that we see, these beautiful monuments, things that can be destroyed in the middle of today. Storms and fires and things that just come around. We put all our pride in our possessions and the things that we have. We put our pride in our car. We want to make it shine up really nice and good. But I'm going to tell you, that Pontiac Grand Am I had a lot of faith and hope in it one time. And it broke down. Transmission went in the middle of New York. I was scared to death. I didn't know which way to turn. What I'm trying to say is that these things that we put so much pride and hope in, these worries that are going through our head, these struggles that we're going through, whatever it be, financially, mentally, physically, spiritually, whatever we're going through, will fade away. But we're looking for a city that's foundation is built and the maker is God. Woo! I want to tell you that this day we can be prepared to step out on faith. That man with 38 years of that infirmity, when Jesus came through, The Bible don't say he spent 39 years in that infirmity. It don't say he spent 38 years and a day in that infirmity. It don't say he spent 38 years and a minute in that infirmity. When Jesus came by and asked if he'd be made whole, he told him to take up his bed and walk. And that's exactly what he did. He didn't have to step inside that pool that he had so much hope in. He stepped out in faith because a man by Jesus came by and called him. So whatever you're going through, just be prepared. Be prepared to pray, and don't quit praying. 1 Thessalonians tells us that, to pray without ceasing. He encourages us that. Psalms tells us to wait on the Lord. And we see in Jeremiah that God already knows our plan. But he has a plan of us for peace and not of evil. You may be watching this right now and you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And you don't know which way to turn. But I'm going to encourage you to take a step out in faith. It's not going to be a bed of roses. I struggle day to day. I've struggled time to time wondering if I'm going to be able to pay this bill or not. I've struggled with sins of this world that just try to take my eyes off Christ. I've struggled with it all. God has never let me down, and he won't let you down. So I want to encourage you here today to step out in faith. Keep your focus on God and just see what happens. God bless you.
You think it's more than you can take, but you're stronger, stronger than you know. Don't you give up now, the sun will soon be shining. You gotta face the clouds to find the silver.